One of the greatest video game success stories of 2018 is the new God of War. I still remember when it was announced back in E3 2016 and was met with trepidation from fans due to how different it looked from previous entries. People wondered if the soft reboot wasn't straying too far off the beaten path, and as a result, the game faced an uphill battle and had a lot to prove. But then the game finally launched on April 20th, 2018, and it was not only met with rave reviews from critics and consumers alike, with many considering it to be nothing short of a masterpiece, it also turned out to be the creative refresh that the series needed. Just familiar enough to please fans, but just new enough to expand its scope of appeal. In its first 3 days, the game managed to push a whopping 3 million copies, and by the end of its launch month, God of War had sold a staggering 5 million copies, making it Sony's fastest-selling first-party game ever across all PlayStation iterations by a long shot. As if all that wasn't enough, it was recently revealed just how well the game did from a financial perspective, and as you might expect, God of War pulled in some very strong numbers. The following information comes from a recent report by market research company Superdata, which published a short but sweet article highlighting data on the continued success of and demand for narrative-driven single-player experiences in the gaming industry. The conclusion tells you everything you need to know, which reads, quote, "The surging emphasis of rich storytelling in games is a key reason why story-driven titles are earning big. During their respective launch months, The Witcher 3 earned $69 million, Uncharted 4 made $56 million, and God of War raked in $131 million in total digital revenue. These results show that there's a significant demand for narrative experiences among gamers." That's right, folks, in just its launch month alone, God of War earned a whopping $131 million. And keep in mind, this data only represents digital sales. I'm sure that number climbs much higher if you add on top of that revenue earned from physical copies sold. This is particularly impressive when you consider that God of War is a PlayStation 4 exclusive, whereas a game like Witcher 3, which earned around half of what God of War did during its launch month, is multi-platform. Granted, Witcher 3 has continued to sell steadily since release, resulting in over 10 million copies being sold by March 2016, less than a year after the game's May 2015 launch, and I'm sure that number has only climbed throughout 2017 and 2018, with CD Projekt Red recently having reported that the Witcher series as a whole has now sold over 33 million copies. Whether God of War can retain a similar momentum in the years to come remains to be seen, but to say that the game is off to a good start would be an understatement. If Uncharted 4 managed to sell close to 10 million copies despite comparatively slower sales, then it's almost assured that God of War will easily exceed 10 million copies in its market lifespan. Sony, of course, is thrilled by God of War's explosive success, recently reporting during a financial briefing that they had strong growth across the board throughout quarter one of the 2018 fiscal year, in no small part due to God of War's unexpectedly strong sales driving both revenue and users to the platform. The best part about all this is that this was all achieved without having to rely on insidious recurrent monetization schemes or some kind of live service model for this title. You're probably well aware by now that God of War director Corey Barlog hasn't shied away from being vocal about his disdain for microtransactions and the false notion that narrative-driven single-player games are dying. Earlier this year, before the game's launch, Corey responded to concerns that God of War might feature microtransactions after a Twitter user noticed some kind of currency in one of the game's screenshots by simply stating, "No freaking way." Before that, back in November 2017, in support of the massive backlash against loot boxes, Corey tweeted a gif of Kratos smashing his fists into a chest alongside the message, "Take that, loot boxes, for now at least." At around the same time, responding to EA's comments on how players don't enjoy linear games as much as they did 5 or 10 years ago, Corey tweeted an image of Picard's famous facepalm alongside the message, "Oh dear God, EA, just utter nonsense." Whereas most other developers might choose to remain silent or complacent, Corey has gone out of his way to rally against false notions and predatory practices in the gaming industry, and it's something that's garnered a lot of admiration from gamers around the world. But more importantly, Corey wasn't just talking out of his ass and actually kept his word. If you've played God of War, then you'll know how easily it could have implemented in-game purchases, with how the game in large part was designed around loot, equipment, and character progression. But instead, it launched pure and completely uncorrupted, and with none of its integrity compromised by monetization bullshit. The result is not only one of the most critically acclaimed games of this generation, but also one of the best-selling single-player games, period. It goes to show that at the end of the day, integrity doesn't need to be sacrificed to be successful or to be profitable as a game publisher or developer. Could God of War have made more money by including microtransactions? Sure. Will it ever earn as much money as some of those live services out there? Probably not. But that's okay, the game still earned a lot of money while leaving an unforgettable mark of prestige on this medium that we all love so much for all the right reasons. Whereas a game like Battlefront 2 will forever be remembered for their controversial aspects, God of War will be remembered for its artistic prowess, and it will only contribute to a strong foundation for the future of the series, and that's something you cannot put a price tag on. Anyway, a merry congratulations to Sony and Santa Monica Studios on this monumental achievement. Let God of War serve as proof, once again, that single-player games are far from dead, that they were never dying in the first place, that they'll never die, period, and that they can coexist with multiplayer experiences or live services, despite what some pundits might say. With that, I would like to end this news update. Thank you for tuning in. If you enjoy my content and would like to support this channel directly, consider donating on Patreon. And to be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out.